once again to the Gwen Margolis Community Center and the May concert of the North Miami Concert Band. My name is Lainey Brooks, and it's my pleasure to act as your guide today through today's performance. Today, our artistic director, Bruce Bailey, has chosen music in honor of the good old USA. From patriotic fantasy to Civil War songs to Ohio, Tennessee, Georgia, and Jersey, I guarantee you that today's musical journey will be another afternoon of amazing music. Without further ado, please give a hearty round of applause as we greet our talented artistic director and conductor, Bruce Bailey. And if you are able, please rise and join Richard Turpin and the band in the Star Spangled Banner. Arranged by Paul Yoder. Dr. Paul Van Buskirk Yoder was an American musician, composer, arranger, and band director, and composed over 1,500 original compositions and arrangements during the course of his career. This gave him the nickname the Dean of American Composers, as well as Fathers of Bands in Japan, and also America's musical ambassador. It is only appropriate that he did the arrangement for the next piece we are about to play by another master who was certainly a patriotic musical ambassador to us all, George M. Cohan. Here now is Patriotic Fantasy featuring, and for those of you who are new, we do sing, we do dance, we do tap. Here now is Patriotic Fantasy featuring Yankee Doodle Boy and You're a Grand Old Flag.
Thank you.
Next up, we have a medley of songs from the Civil War, and all of those of you who were there will certainly be able to sing along. This is called War Songs of the Boys in Blue, and we will be hearing Battle Cry of Freedom, Just Before the Battle, Mother, Tramp, 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 The Vacant Chair, Our Flag Is There, America, and Yankee Doodle. War Songs of the Boys in Blue.
Thank you.
Check out this rip-roaring mix of traditional songs from the American West. This lively mix includes Red River Valley, a unique bluesy setting of the Yellow Rose of Texas, a jaunty whoop-de-yayo, and finishes off with a bright boot-scootin' cotton-eyed Joe. Without further ado, let's go back to the Old West with this hoop-hollerin' arrangement of Saddle Up.
Thank you.
concert of the season, so we won't be having a July 4th concert. And since today was celebrating the good old USA, we wanted to also honor those who served and are serving for us. So today, I would love to ask all of those of you who are able and who served in World War II to please stand, members of the band included. Yay, Flo. And the Korean War. Yeah, wow, there you go. And the Vietnam War. And the Gulf War. The Persian War and the War on Terror. Thank you for all that you do for us. At this time, I would like to call forward U.S. Coast Guard radio man, First Class William Bregman. Sure, come on over here. Mr. Bregman's claim to fame, just so you know, is that he's the father of Carol Bregman, a fantastic flute and piccolo player and many other things, keeps us going. Mr. Bregman joined the Coast Guard in 1942 to 1946. He trained as a radio operator and was assigned to the crew of the destroyer escort ship, the USS Menjes. On his very second trip across the Atlantic, the escort convoy, which included 100 merchant ships, 12 destroyer escorts, and the destroyer USS Lansdale, was attacked in the Mediterranean by German torpedo and bomber planes. The destroyer was sunk, and that night Bregman's ship left the convoy to rescue 200 members of the crew, plus a German pilot and radio operator swimming in the water. Becoming part of another convoy, Bregman's ship was hit by an acoustic torpedo. Damaged but able to stay afloat, and with sonars still working, they were able to give the incoming destroyer escorts the positions of the subs, enabling them to drop depth charges, scattering the German subs. A tug towed Bregman's ship to Algiers to prepare it for a trip back across the Atlantic. The trip back took 2 months, during which time they were using drinking water that was stored in an unused oil tank, since the water tanks had been destroyed. Mr. Bregman says, "We drank mostly tea with a shine on it." Bregman was then assigned to ADEC in the Aleutian Islands as part of a high-frequency direction finder network. Their job was to locate our bomber planes that were shot down while bombing Japan so that the pilots and crews could be rescued. While in ADAC, Bregman heard an urgent message being sent from the Japanese. Since there was no answer, Bregman answered as if he was the Japanese receiver, even asking them to repeat parts of the message to make them believe him more, which they did, enabling him to receive the message and relay it to our guys. Bregman was honorably discharged in 1946, but it wasn't until February 2014 that he received his well-deserved military honors, 10 of them. Among them, the Navy Combat Action Ribbon, the European African Middle Eastern Campaign Medal with 2 bronze stars, and the World War II Victory Medal. Ladies and gentlemen, I present you U.S. Coast Guard radio man, First Class, William Bregman. With yet another award from the North Miami Community Concert Band. No, thank you. Thank you. And now, the band will play, in Mr. Bregman's honor and in all of our military honor, Semper Paratus, the official U.S. Coast Guard marching song. ¶¶ Thank you. Next up is one of my most favorite songs, Sweet Georgia Brown, written by Ben Burney and Maceo Pinkard. Actually, Ben Burney only got writing credit from Pinkard because Ben Burney's then nationally famous orchestra playing at the Roosevelt Hotel did so much to popularize the number. He even gave him a cut of the royalties. Many people have recorded the song, including Bing Crosby, the Beatles, and the Grateful Dead. And the lyrics, which were originally about a black prostitute, seem to vary with each version. The Beatles version contains the line, "In Liverpool, she even dared to criticize the Beatles' hair, with their whole fan club standing there." Today, it is known by many as the theme song of the Harlem Globetrotters basketball team, who use it for their magic circles when the players pass around the ball, displaying their impressive dexterity. Here now is your North Miami concert band displaying their impressive dexterity as they play Sweet Georgia Brown. We love John Philip Sousa. What would an afternoon of music performed by the North Miami Concert Band be without a piece by John Philip Sousa? It's what we do best. Our next piece is from the operetta Al Capitan, which was Sousa's first stage work to achieve great success. So much so that it was performed regularly by leading opera companies for many years. As American music tastes changed, it was performed less often. But the lively march lived to become a staple of bands everywhere and was one of Sousa's favorite encore pieces. Here now, El Capitan with John Philip Sousa.
Thank you. in the early 2000s, Bob Gaudio, an original member of the Four Seasons, sought to make a musical fictional story from their song, similar to Mamma Mia, who got their story from the songs of ABBA. Gaudio, Frankie Valli, and Tom DeVito hired book writers Rick Ellis and Marshall Brickman, who suggested creating a show about the group's real history because in their research, they discovered that the members had prison records, went from rags to riches and back again more times than you can count. Clearly a great story. The Four Seasons said, okay, and made a wise decision to step back from the show's creative process because they lacked objectivity. They did, however, retain final say on whether to end the show if they didn't like it. Well, I guess they liked it. I know I loved it. I hope you do too, as we hear Walk Like a Man, Big Girls Don't Cry, Ragdoll, December 1963, and Can't Take My Eyes Off of You. Here now is Jersey Boys.
Thank you.
2. It's time now to look back at all the outstanding popular songs that kept up America's hope throughout World War II. This outstanding showcase includes Thanks for the Memories, Don't Sit Under the Apple Tree, I'll Be Seeing You, It's Been a Long, Long Time, Bell Bottom Trousers, White Cliffs of Dover, and Praise God and Pass the Ammunition. Homefront, musical memories from World War II. Tennessee Salute pays homage to five legendary melodies that have become a part of America's musical landscape. From folk songs to country romance, this arrangement resonates across generations and all walks of life. Titles include Your Cheatin' Heart, Wabash Cannonball, Chattanooga Choo Choo, Tennessee Waltz, and Rocky Top. Here now is Tennessee Salute.
Thank you.
That was lots of fun. I sit up here and I get to see the audience and I get to see the band. And I get to see you all tapping your feet and smiling, and it really makes us very, very happy. Men of Ohio by Henry Fillmore. Henry Fillmore is one of the world's most famous composers in march music. One of his most popular pieces is Men of Ohio. Composed in 1921, it is dedicated to President Harding. The leader of a shrine band, Fillmore, wrote a piece for them that he considered his best, and so he wanted to put a special dedication to it. Having been born and raised in Ohio, he humbly wrote President Harding, who was also from Ohio, and asked if he could dedicate the march to him. It turned out that the president knew of Fillmore and granted him permission. The dedication reads, "To the President, Warren G. Harding and his staunch loyalists." Here now is Men of Ohio by Henry Fillmore. By Samuel Augustus Ward is an important American patriotic song whose lyrics were written by Catherine Lee Bates and the music was composed by church organist and choir master Samuel A. Ward. Bates originally wrote the words as a poem, Pike's Peak, first published in the July 4th edition of the church periodical The Congregationalist in 1895. Ward had originally written the music for the 1600s hymn, O Mother Dear Jerusalem, in 1882. Ward's music combined with the Bates poem was first published in 1910 entitled America the Beautiful. The song is one of the most beloved and popular of the many American patriotic songs.
Thank you.
want to thank you for helping us make this a wonderful season. As much as you enjoy us, that is exactly how much we enjoy sharing our talents and our love of music with you. Speaking of talents, let us applaud once again Artistic Director Bruce Bailey. We also want to thank the individual members of our band, each of whom brings their unique sound to the group. We want to thank those members of the organization who volunteer their time to do everything from publicity to keeping our music library, our costume department, to greeting you as you arrive. We give special thanks to Drew Freeman for his amazing grant writing and marketing skills. And most especially for the tremendous amount of time and effort he has put into both. We especially need to thank the City of North Miami and Miami-Dade County for their invaluable support. And we want to thank you for your kind donations.